All right, so we're going to do a fantastic experiment, known as the Elephant's Toothpaste Experiment, but I tell you what, this experiment's going to be a bit of fun because it's Halloween and we're going to make a total mess. You cool with that?
Yeah.
All right, so what we're going to do, we've got some water here and I've dissolved a few tablespoons worth of potassium iodide, a catalyst which is going to help this thing turn a whole bunch of foamy stuff with our chemical over here. So I tell you what, we're going to make it colourful first. So Jack, can I get you to pour in some green food colouring into there? That's the way, mate. Pour it in, pour it in, pour it in. That's plenty. Excellent. Good job. So give that a nice mix. But it's not going to foam if you don't have some detergent. So Matilda, can you pour in some detergent, please? And give it a good squeeze. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Look, 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 look. Let's go nuts. Go nuts. Go nuts. Give it a good squeeze. There we go. So we've got some detergent. We've got some water. We've got some food colouring. We're going to put this into our pumpkin. And we're going to make a bit of a mess. All right, you're working on your mess with your food colouring now, aren't you, mate? All right, so we're going to pour it in. In we go. Nice and green. Good job, Jack. All right, so we've got our food colouring. You know what, Matilda, let's give it another good squirt for luck with detergent. We'll give it a really good squirt. Squirt, squirt, squirt. That'll give you a good squeeze. Lots of it. Done. Now, all we've added right now is water and potassium iodide and some colour and detergent. Now the potassium iodide won't do anything in this chemical reaction, but it will help another chemical break up. And that one is quite strong. It's called hydrogen peroxide. Now hydrogen peroxide is used for bleaching hair and it's kind of strong. In fact, the one that you get at your pharmacies, there's about 6% strength. This stuff is 35% strength, which means it's really strong lab stuff. So you're not exactly going to get this at home, but I tell you what, it's really good if you're in a high school. So, I think what we're going to do is we're going to pour our very strong hydrogen peroxide, our H2O2, into here, and it's going to react into some water and some oxygen. We're going to trap a whole bunch of bubbles. Let's see how this goes. You ready? 3, 2, 1, let's pour it on in. I'm going to put the cap on too. Whoa, put it on in. It's reacting. It's reacting, it's reacting, it's reacting. I'm not gonna be, oh, it's on its way! Look at it! Whoa! It's almost very creepy too, the way that came on out. Now, what actually happened is the hydrogen peroxide broke up into some very safe water and oxygen, and it used the potassium iodide as a catalyst to help break it up in the first place. Notice there's a whole bunch of steam coming off it, and that's because it's quite exothermic, which means it releases a whole bunch of heat energy in the process. Now, if you want to do this at home, all you need is some 6% hydrogen peroxide. You can get it from your local pharmacy or drugstore if you're in North America, and use that 6% peroxide with some water and some yeast. But for now, this is a fun experiment, and it's a bit of a take on elephant's toothpaste.